Everyone, welcome to Sarod Mishra's mathematics tutorials. We already covered the basics of Laplace transform, deriving standard formula using Laplace transform first principle in previous lectures. So please refer those lectures to understand the basics of Laplace transform. Now I will be starting exam crack series for Laplace transform. This is specially designed to score better in university exams. Here, all university favorite questions are picked up, which are repeatedly asked in most of the university exams. And all the problems are solved in easiest possible ways. Apart from identifying important questions from examination point of view and their solutions, basic concepts based on integration, differentiation, etc. are also being explained here nicely. The entire effort is to boost students' confidence for the particular topic and score better. So please subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and boost my confidence as well. So we will be starting exam crack series for Laplace transform. Now, before I start a problem, I will cover few basic concepts like integration based. We are already aware of ILATE in integration. ILATE, this I stands for inverse trigo, L for logarithm, algebraic function, trigonometric function, E stands for exponential function. ILATE property is used for integral of product of two functions. Whenever we have product of two functions and it has to be integrated, then the ILATE property is used. That we are very much aware. Still, a quick revision of that. I stands for inverse trigo functions. Inverse trigo functions like sine inverse, cos inverse, tan inverse. Inverse of all trigonometric functions. L stands for logarithmic functions like log x. Algebraic functions which will include x constants. Trigonometric functions we are aware like cos x, sin x, tan x and all those. Exponential function, for example e raised to the power x. ILATE property is used for product of, for integral of product of two functions. Now let us move for an example. Keeping this in mind, suppose we have x dx. Now, identify x is an algebraic function and ex is exponential function. So, in this sequence, whichever is coming first, algebraic function and exponential function, these two we have right now in this problem. So, between these two, whichever is coming first, that is taken as u. that is taken as u and another function is taken as v. I hope it is clear. We look at it from top to down, whichever is coming first. Here x is algebraic and ex is an exponential function. Algebraic function is coming first and this is coming next. So algebraic function will be taken as u, the first function coming in the series, and the second will be taken as v. And further, the integral of u v is done like this. Integral uv is equal to, u is taken out as it has been identified the first function, so u will be kept out. Integral of v is taken minus, first u is differentiated, v is integrated. V is integrated, u is differentiated, and the product is again integrated. This is the product rule of integration using ILATE property. Product of two functions uv, integration, u is taken out, v is integrated first, afterwards putting a minus sign, u is differentiated, v is integrated, the product is taken, and again the product value, final value is integrated once again. So this dx is for v integral and this dx is final product integral. So this is the product integration using ILATE. Now let us move ahead. So far we covered that any function is given, then using first principle, Laplace first principle, function is multiplied with e raised to the power minus st, integrated under the limit 0 to infinity, and we used to get the result. Suppose Laplace of sin t using first principle, then this needs to be calculated. This type of things we have already done in the previous lectures, Laplace of any function using first principle. Now, mostly one question in university exams is based on first principle. But what type of problem is mostly asked based on first principle? Suppose a function is given when function is not a single quantity, now it is split up as two, and some limits are also, some values of t also given. So this is university favorite question. Why? Because students are going to stuck in understanding the problem, how to solve the question further, because it has been split up as two, and then further students do stuck in integrating the values, so that it becomes university favorite question. Let us move ahead for this. Before moving ahead, we'll explain you that how will it be written. Laplace of ft is equal to but what do we see, that ft is not a single quantity, it is now split up for 0 to 4, when t is 0 to 4, the limit 0 to infinity is for t, that we are aware. The limit values are for t. Now t is not a constant function, it is breaking. In the interval 0 to 4, the function is t. In the interval 0 to 4, the function is t. And beyond 4, up to infinity, function value becomes 5. So then we need to split the integral into 2, because limits are split up. So as the limits are split up and two separate functions we have, therefore we need to split up and write two integrals. One with the limit 0 to 4 e minus st ft plus further lower limit will be 4 onwards infinity e raised to the power minus st ft. This needs to be written in a line. Hope this is clear. Integration is split up now as the limits t values and function values are different. So 0 to 4 ft and 4 to infinity. Further, function value is t. And 4 to infinity, the function value is 5. Now we will proceed ahead. First of all, we can write it as integral 1 and integral 2. We can deal Laplace of ft can be written as I1 plus I2. Further, we will put the values here once I1 and I2 values are calculated. Because going ahead simultaneously sometimes makes students confused. So, better we deal with I1 and I2 separately. Now, I2 can be given priority because it has a constant with e to the power minus st and going to be easier to solve. So first of all we will start with here 5 is a constant, so it can be kept out. When we integrate e raised to the power minus st, I have already discussed integration of e raised to the power minus st and also putting limits. So please refer the previous lectures for understanding the complete integral of e and limit etc. So integral of e raised to the power minus st is minus st and the quantity minus s is multiplied with t. Quantity minus s is multiplied with t. So it comes in denominator after integration. And the limits will be substituted now. We already discussed that e raised to the power minus infinity is nothing but 0. That has been covered in the previous lecture. E raised to the power minus infinity, this is upper limit which is substituted first, and on putting infinity here, e raised to the power minus infinity becomes 0. Next we put a minus sign before the lower limit and this will become e raised to the power, we put in place of t not s. S is not 4, S is a constant here. Because integral is in terms of t, then S is a constant here. So we are putting 4 in place of t. So we'll have e raised to the power minus 4s, and in denominator we have minus s. Further, this minus and this minus becomes plus. So we have 5 e raised to the power minus 4s. This 4 is limit one. 5, this minus minus plus, e raised to the power minus 4s. So we have integral I2 is equal to, we can note it down somewhere, I2 is equal to 5 e raised to the power minus 4s upon s. Next line we can write here, 5 e raised to the power minus 4s upon s. This is I2 value, which we have to give some number, maybe 2 or 3. We will put it back here in 1. Next, move ahead for integral I1. As it is clear that product of 2, so we are going to use ILATE, which has already been discussed. I2 will be please recall the ILATE property again, ILATE, I-L-A-T-E. So T is algebraic function here, T means X, and E is exponential. So if we write it horizontally, then which one is come first, or if we write it vertically, whichever is coming first. So T is coming first, this will be taken as U. Hope it is clear. In the sequence, a algebraic function t is coming first will be taken as u, and hence another will be taken as v. And we know u is kept out, and integral of v minus write it in rough somewhere, u integral of v dx minus derivative of u with integral of v, and the product again integrated. So this we have to apply here. So u is t, one by one we will keep the values. From here we can write t, we will write outside, better to start here. U is equal to t integral of e raised to the power minus st dt minus derivative of t. Derivative of t is, we are aware, derivative of t, derivative of dx by d by dx of x is 1. D by dx of x is 1. So d by dt of t is 1. What I am saying, d by dx of x is 1. So we know this differentiation. So d by dt of t will also be 1. So directly we can write derivative of t is 1 into integral of v minus st upon minus s. Just now we did it for I2. Next, minus s. Once more, integral will be taken for e raised to the power minus st, and this will leave one more minus. And we have to put the limits. Limits are 0 to 4. Hope everything is clear up to this point. Please note down properly. We are going to put the upper limit in place of t first, and then 0 in place of t. First of all, in both the terms, t equal to 4 will be substituted. I am writing it here now. So, putting 4, if we put 4 here, this minus can be taken up. E raised to the power minus 4s. Putting 4 here, 1 minus, 2 minus and 3 minus. Finally, we will have minus e raised to the power minus 4s again upon s square. Now the lower limit, for putting lower limit, we put a minus sign, and then again 0 will be substituted here. What we see that t, putting 0 in place of t will make entire thing 0. So this entire part will become 0. Minus sign will affect the final sign. It has minus sign, so minus minus plus. Further we can do. If we are confused, we can write a minus sign here before taking the lower limit, and afterwards we can break the bracket. So now it is putting 0 here, e raised to the power 0, e raised to the power 0, e raised to the power 0 is 1. Any finite quantity raised to power 0 is 1. Any finite number raised to the power 0 is 1. So e raised to the power 0 will give 1. So I am writing it here, or here also we can write 1 upon the s square. Now we have minus 4 by s, e to the power minus 4s. Minus and minus plus 1 s square. This is I1 value. Now we have to put the value of I1 and I2 back in equation. The numbering we have done here, 1 for Laplace of ft. For Laplace of ft, we have to substitute the value I1 and value I2. So putting the values here, putting I1 and I2 in 1, we get Laplace ft equal to minus 4 by s, this entire thing, minus upon s square plus 1 upon s square, and we have I2 here. Plus 5 e raised to the power minus 4s upon s. Now this minus 4 upon s, this quantity and this quantity are same, having different numbers. So this 5 minus 4, others are different because it has square. It doesn't have e. So these are different. But these two are identical, e to the power minus 4s upon s, here also, but number is 5 and 4. Like suppose we have 5a minus 4a, then we can subtract or add. So a, this way only, this will become, if we consider it a, the plus 5a, and this becomes minus 4a. So will give us a. Combining these two, we will get a, which is, so we have e raised to the power minus 4s upon s minus e raised to the power minus 4s upon s square, this value, and plus 1 upon s square. This is the answer for Laplace of the given function which is in the split up form. That's all for today's session. Please subscribe if you like it. Thank you very much.